Hi, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about Lamy. This is not a review, so I won't be doing any writing samples. I will just be talking about the Lamy Safari Special Edition strategy that Lamy is following. This is just my opinion. I didn't speak with Lamy about it. This is what I think. So I just want to go around a little bit about the choice of colors they have made. So, I don't care for the box. It was just here to illustrate that I'm going to talk about Lamy, and let's go for the pens. So, when we think about Lamy and about Lamy Safari, we know that every year there is a special edition for that specific year. And I'm going to talk about the strategy they've been following since 2016. And in 2016, they decided to go for this color. This one is the dark lilac finish. And I think this was a very interesting choice because there are a lot of people that are into this kind of purplish colors, and it has a black trim, a matte finish, and I really believe that dark colors with black trim are nice, and the matte finish is also something very nice for this pen. So this is what they released in 2016. And in 2017 they went the same path. They created this is the Petrol. It is very beautiful. They also made a color that matched the pen, also for this one, but this color, the ink color was very sought for, so I think this was a very nice choice. What changes between this pen and that one? Just the color choice. This has a blue, a Petrol blue color, and that one has a dark lilac color. But some people may be surprised because they found out that in 2 years in a row, Lamy went for the same kind of aesthetic choice. But I think the real surprise was when in last year, 2018, they went for this. This is the all black version. This all black version is what? Exactly the same kind of philosophy of those ones. Black, trim, nib, matte color, matte finish, and it has a dark color. It couldn't be darker. It is black. This was something that people thought, okay, this is really a lack of imagination because they already made two dark colors with matte finish and black trim, and also this one may be a lack of imagination to do the same thing, to do just a black pen for a special edition. But why wouldn't they make a black pen? Because they already had they didn't have a black pen, although many people used to look at this, which is the charcoal or umbra finish from the regular edition. They think or they consider this a black one. And when we look at them like this, they really look the same color. But if you check my blog, you can see the real difference in color between those two pens because I have their photos, which are easier to see than in video. So they went for a not so obvious choice, and I think this was one of the smartest moves they ever made, because they decided the simplest color of all. Lots of people like black pens. Many Lamy Safari collectors show themselves to be angry with this, saying, "Why a black pen?" But if they are collectors, I think they bought the pen anyway, because then they will miss a slot in their collection. Also, people who like stealth bands went for it, and in a Lamy Safari range that is usually quite bright and flashy, this would be the most understated pen they could have. Also, because this is so close to the regular edition, there was lots of discussion and people saying, no, they are exactly the same color. They are not. But for many people, for their eye capacity of seeing colors, they are the same. So this generated so much curiosity, then these pens sold out because the controversy helps the sales. And I believe many Lamy, non-Lamy fans also bought this pen because of the discussion. And also, they got very interested in the next year edition, so 2019, because maybe they never looked at the Safari this way. I think this pen was a huge boost in sales and also a good entry spot into the Safari, Lamy Safari collection. And then in 2019, this year, people start thinking, and now which color will they choose? And they went into a very, very different path. And they choose pastel colors, which I think it was also a very, very intelligent thing. These are very light colors, very soft, because they are pastel colors. They changed many things. The top of the cap is no longer black, it is of the color of the pen. The trim is chrome trim. Also the nib is still nib in its natural color. And the pens have these three colors and are very glossy. And what does this make to the collection? After the dark colors, they went for bright colors or light colors. Many people like pastel colors, and this is no longer a gender-related choice. Both men and women and children and elder people may choose these kind of pens because they look great. These colors are very beautiful. And if I don't like blue, I can choose pink or green. Or just because they are cheap enough, maybe I will get the blue one and the pink one. And if I am in these two out of three, why don't I go for the three? So what I think they made, they widened the choice. In those previous years, if you wanted a special edition, you had to go for the only color that was available as a special edition that year. And in 2019, you can choose one of three, or two of three, or even three of three. And this is what I think that happened. Many people in 2019 would, and maybe still will, choose to buy the three pens because they are inexpensive enough, because you'll get all the slots covered in your collection, and these are very nice colors. Also, because of this sudden change from the black version to the real colorful ones, I think now everyone is thinking about next year's collection. And if people are already thinking, what will Lamy come out for the Lamy Special Edition for 2020, I think they are in the road to even more success. Because if you like the pens now, you'll be very aware when they are released, the new version again, and you'll go for it. And I believe they will go for it anyway, if this is a real consensual or if it originates a lot of discussion. Consensus or controversy are two very good things for success. So, this is all for today. I have to say, these five pens Not this one, but these 5 pens were provided to me by Fontoplume for review. If you want to get these 3, the 2019 collection, you can go to Fontoplume's website and buy them. And so thank you Fontoplume for that. And if you like the video, please don't forget to subscribe and to be coming back for more videos like this. So until next time, bye.